Hello, AcroJazz. This is a warm-up, conditioning, and stretch that you all can do. Please start this before we give you the class content for each week. This will be roughly around 15 to 20 minutes, so enjoy.
And then this next time we're going to push up and we're going to put our toes on our head, attempting to, at this point your knees can come apart just a little bit, but don't let them come much further than your hips and your shoulders, because we really want to focus more on the back flexibility than we do our hips right now. Very good. Woo. Turning over. We are going to do our bridges. We can do it. Oh, goodness. But first, let's roll into a ball and stretch our back just a little bit. Up now. Okay, here we go. Nice and long. And we should be ready. We're going to push up into our bridges and we will hold it for 10.
Y'all follow Jordan. I'm having like a
reaction. Oh, no. I don't know. Okay, here we go. again. You work hard, you want this. Okay, for the next exercise, I'm not gonna do the whole thing with you, but you have to do a total of 20 rocks. So that's rock hand to foot, and for each rock, either forward or backward, it counts as one. So I'll do the demonstration for like maybe six, and then I'll count it out. You guys keep going even if I go. Here we go. Ooh, pushing up. Feet in one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Awesome job. Roll it out again.
Thank you.
My computer is like completely losing its mind, guys, and we're all going viral. Jamie! Thank goodness Mr. Patrick has his. Okay, so we have one more thing that we need to do, and it is the long-legged extension prances. So we'll do a slow set of 10 and a quick set of 10. And what's most important is the leg is straight. The others, they're kind of a little bit more simplistic. This one is very important for your leg is straight, and the whole goal is to get the leg as high up to the ceiling as possible. The goal is for the toe to be pointing at the ceiling, not at like a corner of the wall to the ceiling or down at the mirror. So get that leg as high as possible, engage your core muscles, and get it up. Also, with all of this, it's very important that we have our weight where? On our hands. Because the whole goal for this is to be working on our balance and getting our weight distribution in the proper place. For walkovers, for back handsprings, for front handsprings, for any type of trick that we do that shifts our weight from one direction to the next. You can't do these, you can't do those. So let's do the extension prances really quickly. I will only be doing four again. I love you guys.
Those knees to go over your feet, not too narrow, not too wide. Down and up, down and up. Few more. Three, two, one. We're gonna speed it up and down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, inhale. Keep going. And 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, give a little like swing in circle. Give your hips a rest. Now we're gonna do the same thing, except in like a wider stance. Nice wide second position, you guys, especially if you're in a base, should be used to this.
For your first partnering, most importantly, and my double cartwheel girls, really think about those muscles for this, okay? That's what we're hearing this time. Thank you.
Here we go. Keeping it at a slow rate. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8.
Keep your chest up.
9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. A bit faster now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Done. Go ahead, give your hips some love, going side to side. Now, go ahead and get your legs to the mat. We're going to be doing squats, side-to-side squats. Here we go. You're good. 5, 6, 7, 8, and right or your left, my right. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Same thing, but this time we're going to flex the foot. So flex, flex. Getting a little stretch in those hamstrings, if you will. And 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, bend down. And bring the feet together. And slowly set your knees down. Next up, we're gonna be working our shoulders. This is a bit of a doozy. These push-ups are modified for dancers, so that way we're working our shoulder rotators instead of keep holding it in like a military push-up, which is basically this, leaving 1 inch off the ground. You're actually gonna go all the way down and come back up. So you do have a little bit of a baby break in between each one. There's two different versions. There is the one that I just did, a full plank, going all the way down, and coming all the way up. Then there is the modified version. You start off in plank, bring your knees down,
See how I'm still in that straight line from my plank? Wrap your feet, come back down, and lift up, and up. It is your choice which if you want to do the full plank or the modification. I'm going to do the full plank for the
modification.
So it is
not a question.
Yes.
A beat. So you're doing it. So it starts with plank. Mm-hmm. And it goes drop, wrap, down, up, back, up. Do I just
stay down? You
would
come back up.
Oh, so, mm-hmm. Okay, so it is that little
beat.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, guys.
You can start with your phone. Okay, that's your question.
Well,
and
you guys
if you want it to help you go faster, because these do go a little bit faster, you want to make these wrap as soon as possible. So,
okay.
Here, down, and up.
So it unwraps as you're coming.
Yeah.
Okay. How many are we doing?
We're doing 3 sets of 8, so all together that's 24.
But we're having a break for each shape?
Yes.
There
you
go.
Here we go.
Oh.
It is up to you if you want to work on your triceps. Your arms are closer to your chest. If you want to work your bicep, they're like a little bit spaced in between. I would say underneath your shoulders. It's up to you.
And elbows go back towards your body.
Yes.
That was a bad don't do it. I was just making sure my arms. I prefer the ones that go in nice and tight.
Well, she'll be working on the triceps. I'm going to be doing biceps.
And there you go.
5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. Come up. And 2. Come up. And 3. Come up. And 4. Come up. 5, up, 6, up, 7, up, 8, up. Go down to child's pose, giving your shoulders a nice break. That's just the first set. We got 2 more to go.
I like that. Sorry.
You're good. Here we go.
Ready?
5, 6, 7, 8, and
down.
This is 2. And 3. And 4. And 5. And 6, 7, and 8. Come back into child's pose. Well, I did this yesterday and I did like sturdy up drum. So knowing that I'm cutting it down by 6 is nice. That's what I did. And last set, because this is good for you. 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. And 2. And 3. And 4. And 5. And 6. And 7. Last one. And lift your shoulders to the bottom. But you feel like your shoulders.
My whole body shaking. I feel like if your body is shaking, you definitely hit your goal.
Yes.
My body is shaking, guys.
We're almost there. So, the next exercise is good for your back and your core. You're also working the flexibility of your hamstrings as well.
Love that.
Yes. Just do 8 of them. I did 20 yesterday and I gave myself 4. So I'm just giving you guys 8 to do.
But maybe you guys could do 8 a day.
Yes.
That might be a classroom. Mm-hmm. By the way, guys, check your classrooms. We'll be giving you homework. Mm-hmm. We love you.
So, if you want, I can demonstrate first.
I'm getting prepped and ready to go.
All right. So, extending out all the way, in, you can kind of see me. From here,
yes.
You are lifting up. You're pressing your lower back into the floor, coming back down. You're going to roll over to one side, landing on your belly, and then you're going to lift up, pressing forward. And then rolling over, nice and controlled. That was just considered one. Coming up, down, going the other way. Nice and controlled. Up, and back to the side. That's two.
You guys can do it.
So, here we go. Ready to form a lot this time.
I might just
and 5, 6, 7, 8. You go up and down. Roll over and down. Lift up and down. Roll over and down. That's one, come up and down. Roll over and down. Lift up and down. Roll over. That was two. Up, down, over, down, up, down, roll over. Down, three, down. I'm saying if you do this nice and controlled, this is so good for you.
This is number 4. Awesome, starting 5. Six. Almost there, guys. Last 2. 1. Or 7. Like a mat or a carpet. That's why I stopped, because I was doing 2 sets and I already was starting to feel bruises on all my protruding bones. Going bony like me. You will know what I'm talking about. Just PSA.
Anyways, we only have 2 more exercises to go. Well, technically 3, but the 3rd one's more of your core. So for the 2nd one, you are going to, we have done these before. We just haven't done them because we were crashing recital material. But
which
you guys,
thank you guys so much for finishing with us.
Yes.
Oh my God.
We're going to go against the wall. I'm just pretending that this is the wall. Making sure hips are up and engaged and you stay stuck, sticking to that wall, slash mirror, using your back, controlling you all the way down. Yeah. Up slowly, but surely. I'm not gonna do this with you because you guys won't be able to see me that much anyway. But I would like for you to do them, what, 10 times? 10 times is good enough.
10 times, whether or not you go all the way down or come back up. You can tailor it to your body and where you're at the moment. I know that we haven't practiced in a while, but definitely push yourself, but do not drop anything. Keep your bodies healthy, okay? We love you guys so much. We don't want anything. So.
And then our last one, we have done these also. You're going to go up against the wall at first. And you're going to do your handstand balances. So, if I were to demonstrate, I'll just go back here.
You have two different kinds. You can walk up with your belly facing the wall. Make sure your toes are pointed so you can flutter off of the wall. Awesome. And then we also have the ones where you are facing away from the wall and you are picking up as though it's a regular handstand. I will attempt this. I love y'all so much. Oh, it worked.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And then we flutter. Oh, I can't let you hold it. Find it. Also, guys, make sure you do some flutters. You know how we just try and kick off really small, trying to figure out how much energy we need to use for the push off. But then also, while you're up there, do like maybe 10 flutters of each style. And then what I would like you to do is try and kick off, find that balance, and spell your name. After you are done with the wall, guess what? You do it in the center. Yay! Same thing, try and just find that balance, and once you get that feel for it, spell your name. Start with first name, add second name, possibly your last name if you're feeling fancy. You can either just count up how many it is and just count, or you can literally spell it. I know my sister and I used to love just spelling it. We're like, how fast can we spell it? And then what else do you have?
Your homework assignment. Go outside if it's not muddy and whatnot. Or not, just do this in your room. Your living room / den. The biggest part of your house.
The biggest room. That is the goal.
And you are going to do pop-ups. All the way across and all the way back.
Other than stay. If you were in, I know Alex and Kate, you both will remember these. We kind of touched on these in this class and last year, but if you were in my strength and conditioning like 3 or 4 years ago, wrong tag. We did these across the blue room, the biggest classroom. We went back and forth, but anyway, so you're in your plane, and I need to be on that also. You're in your plane, and all you're doing is you're using your shoulder muscles to pop off. And guys, this is not a race. This is not a race. Every motion, you should only travel a little bit. Most of the motions should be up. And you should really be engaging your core. I'm certain that was like an atrocious example. But everything should be nice and tight as though you are holding your plank. The only difference is your shoulders and your toes are pushing up off the ground, and you're also using a little bit of your fingers. Because your shoulders are doing that. Homework. Okay.
Your homework is to count how many pop-ups you are able to do across the room and back.
Or yard. Basically, we just want to challenge y'all.
All right, that is your warm-up, conditioning, and whatnot. Have a good day.